सेवा लक्षितात्मानं साभ्यामवोचत। आफ्टर लिविंग ए लाइफ ऑफ ब्रह्मचर्य सर्विंग द मास्टर प्रजापति द आत्मा विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू आईज इज पॉइंटेड आउट टू इंद्र एंड विरोचना बाय प्रजापति इन हिज टीचिंग। द टीचिंग इज अक्षि उपलक्षित आत्मा करस्पॉन्डिंग टू द श्रुति मंत्र यः एषः अक्षिणी पुरुषः दृश्यते। दिस पुरुष विच इज सीन इन द आईज। Let us now see what exactly was implied by Prajapati in his teaching, that is, Yaha Eshaha Akshini Purushaha Drishyate, or as specified in Stanza 14 as Akshi Lakshitam Atmanam. So, Vidyaranyamuni, for our easy understanding, is giving us the import of Prajapati's teaching. Stanza 15. Purnatvat purusho yosti paramatmayam akshini jagrat sakshitaya sthitva vidvadhisu vibhavyate. अन्वय पूर्णत्वात् पुरुषः अक्षिणि स्थित्वा जागृत साक्षितया यः परमात्मा अस्ति एड सः अक्षिणि स्थित्वा जाग्रत साक्षितया यः परमात्मा अयम् अस्ति एड सः विद्वद्भिः सुविभाव्यते। विद्वद्भिः सुविभाव्यते। फर्स्ट व्हाट इज मेंट बाय पुरुष, नॉट ए मैन इन कॉन्ट्रास्ट टू वुमन। सो पूर्णत्वात् पुरुषः, so one who is purna, being purna, one who is full and complete. What do you mean by full and complete? That and that alone is there, there is nothing other than itself. So the all-pervasive advaya, the advaya tattva alone can be purna. Rest all are apurna, being subjected to limitations, parichinnata. Purnatva purushaha. What is Purusha, Atma, Brahma? Where is it? What is it? Says, Akshini Sthitva, abiding in the I, E-Y-E-I. So, abiding in the I, Akshini Sthitva, what does it do? Jagrat Sakshitaya Yaha, Yaha, that Purusha who is abiding in the Akshi, the I. Here, E-Y-E-I, Akshi, is Upalakshana for all Indriyas. So, Akshini Sthitva, Jagrat Sakshitaya, as the very Sakshi, the illuminator, one who makes us aware of all the waking state experiences, Jagrat Sakshitaya. The definition of Jagrat, you know, Indriyaihi Arthopalabdhihi. So, having the sense perceptions through the indriyas, this is not only for jnanendriyas, upalakshana for karmendriya also, taking to karmas, actions through indriyas. So, through jnanendriyas, sense perception, through karmendriyas, action. So, that is what is indriyaihi arthopalabdhihi. That is what is jagrat jagritam. So here, this purusha abiding in the eye, in the sense abiding all the indriyas, takes to the jagrat state, experiences. How does it abide there? Sakshitaya, as the sakshi, the one who illuminates all these experiences through indriya. As you know, the vishayakara antakarana vrittis get illumined by the sakshi paramatma. So that's why it is said as abiding in the akshi or indriya. The question comes, why that akshini, so is that I only is taken? Because as per the other Upanishad, that is Brahadaranyak Upanishad, in the waking state, Jagrat Kali, the Sakshi Paramatma, where is it available? Dakshinakshini Virajate, in the right eye. That's why he is called, Atma is called as Dakshinakshi Purushaha, with respect to the waking state of consciousness. Not that Atma is only in the right eye, Atma is everywhere, but right eye being prominent in the waking state, so it is considered to be the headquarter, as it were, not literally. So that's why the Atma is called Dakshinakshi Purushaha. So this is told in Brahadaranyaka Upanishad. So this right eye is considered as the seat of Atma, because Dakshinakshi is most prominent. But through that, it refers to the Chit Chaitanya, because of which not only right eye, but also the left eye and all indriyas are able to function in terms of perception and karma during the waking state. This is what was hinted earlier as Chakshushaha Chakshuhu, as per Kenopanishad. Pranasya Pranam Chakshushaha Chakshuhu. The one cause of which sense organs and organs of actions are capable of functioning. So that is referred to as Jagrat Sakshitaya, as the illuminator of all the waking state experiences. Yaha, whatever, Ayam Paramatma, this Paramatma which you have asked, which both of you have asked, Paramatma, Asti, is there. But how to know that in right eye or in eyes we may not be able to see the Atma? No, it is known by Vidvadbhi Suvibhavyate. Vidvadbhi Suvibhavyate. What is Vidvadbhi? Yogi Bhihi. By yogis. What is yogis? Dhyayi Bhi. Those who with Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti, with Antakarana Shuddhi, those who take to investigation into the nature of Atma and thereafter contemplate, meditate on Atma Swarupa, they are the Vidvadbhi, Yogibhi, Dhyayibhi, those who meditate. For them, by them, Vidvadbhi, by these Vidvani, by these Yogis, by these Dhyayi, the meditators, by these meditators, Suvibhavyate is discovered, is perceived, is contemplated upon. So therefore, this is what that Purusha who is Purna, full and complete, can be cognized as the one because of which all waking state experiences, whether they are through Jnanendriyas or through Karmendriyas, all are illumined, all are made known, and therefore this Paramatma is available as Sakshi in the waking state. Of course, having with reference to right eye as a prominent place of its manifestation. Now one may say, if Atma, Paramatma, is the Sakshi, the knower, the illuminator of all the experience of the waking state, how do you say there is something called a Paramatma Tattva? Each and every one of us as an individual, we see, we hear, we taste, we do, or walk, we talk, all this. Is it not this individual jiva, the vyakti, is the sakshi, the illuminator, or one who makes know all these things? No, only aviveki people think so. This Paramatma, Brahma alone, is the Sakshi, and not the Karta, Bhokta, Jiva can be Sakshi. So therefore, Parabrahma alone is Sakshi, and not the Jiva, who is endowed with Kartrutva and Bhoktrutva. This is elaborated by Vidyarana Muni. Chichaya vana hankaraha mudai ratmeti bhavyate. Karta bhokta sajivaha syatara brahmaiva sakshasau. Karta bhokta sajivasya parabrahmaiva sakshasau. मूढ़ैः चिच्छायावान् अहंकारः आत्मा इति भाव्यते. सः कर्ता भोक्ता जीवः स्यात्, परब्रह्म एव असौ साक्षी. परब्रह्म एव असौ साक्षी. जीव कैनॉट बी साक्षी, रेफर टू इन अर्लियर स्टैंडर्ड एंड टीचिंग ऑफ प्रजापति. सो हु टेक दैट टू बी सो, हु टेक जीव एज साक्षी? दीज पीपल हु आर दो मूढ़ ही भाव्यते. इट इज कंसिडर्ड सो. Jiva is considered as the Sakshi by Mudha people. Mudhai means aviveki bhihi, those people who lack Atma Anatma Viveka. By such aviveki bhavyate, it is considered, they take it to be so. What they take it to be so? Chichayavan ahankaraha आत्मा इति भाव्यते. दिस अहंकार, अहंकार रेफर्स टू जीव. हु इज दैट? चिच्छायावान्, द वन एंडोर्ड विद चिदाभास. वन एंडोर्ड विद चिदाभास इन द सेंस स्थूल शरीर, सूक्ष्म शरीर एंडोर्ड विद चिदाभास, वेर इन दिस एम्बॉडीमेंट इज मिस्टेकन एज आई. By this ahankara, erroneous notion, so therefore this ahankara stands for jiva, is mistaken, bhavyate, considered or mistaken by the avivekis as atma. And is it not sakshi atma? No. The one who is endowed with chichaya, along with gross and subtle body, taking this embodiment as I, the ahankara, is actually jiva. So therefore, saha, karta, bhokta, jiva. So he is the jiva who is karta, doer of all actions, bhokta, experiencer of all the experiences. Actually, actions are done at the level of upadhi. Manasa, sankalpa, buddhya, nishchitya, karanaihi, karma, karoti. Again, these experiences are presented in terms of antakarana vritti, and the individual is the bhokta, because atma being nirupadhika, there is no bhoga of vishayas or samsara to atma. Bhokta saha karta bhokta jivaha sya. So what is mistaken by atma, by aviveki, is nothing but jiva. Then who is this sakhi? Parabrahma itself is asau. Asau means this. Proximity is pointed out. Who is this? The one who is available as I, Atma, in this embodiment. This Parabrahma, Chaitanya Swarupa Parabrahma, itself is a Sakshi, so, and not the Jiva. Prajapati, having pointed out the Purusha and the Akshi as Atma, so further describes the same Atma as Brahma Swarupa, which is indestructible and which is totally free from bhaya, the fear. Fear means samsara. Fear stands for samsara. So the teaching of Prajapati continues like this. Etat amrutam abhayam etat brahma 874. This is amrutam, immortal, indestructible. This Purusha itself is abhaya, free from fear, free from samsara. Itself etat brahma. So how is it amrutam? How is it abhaya? So then that is which is nothing but Brahma, is described. Before that, take a correction. In the first line of Sandha 17, Tadiryate is the last phrase. Tadiryate, correct as Taditiryate. What you have to do is the strike it. Strike the and in its place add diti. Diti. Taditiryate. If you break the sandhi, tad iti iryate. Taditiryate. Take the stanza. Brahmano maranabhava. Amrutvam taditiryate. Amrutvam taditiryate. Advitiyataya bhiti. Hetva bhavaccha nirbhayam. Anvaya marana bhavat brahmana amrutvam. Another correction is that it is not amrutvam, amrutatvam. In this book it is so, in other reading it is amrutatvam. So therefore it is like, let us read the stanza again. Brahmano maranabhava amrutatvam taditiryate advitiyataya bhiti hetva bhavaccha nirbhayam. Anvaya marana bhava brahmanaha amrutatvam ad bhavati. Amrutatvam ad bhavati tad advitiyataya bhiti hetva bhavaccha. Bhiti hetva bhavaccha nirbhayam iti iryate. Nirbhayam iti iryate. So Brahma is amrita, immortal, indestructible. Why? Maranabhava. Maranabhava, because of absence of any death, destruction, Brahmanaha amrutatvam bhavati. Brahma happens to be immortal Amrita. So whatever that is subject to death or destructible is not Amrita. Brahma is indestructible and therefore it is Amrita. It has no death at all. Whatever that is born is subject to change and destruction. Brahma is unborn, with nirvikari, and therefore no destruction, no death. Tad. Tad means Brahma, that Brahma which is Amrita. Tad, Brahma, also is nirbhaya. Abhaya, it is free from fear, free from sorrows of samsara. Why? Advitiyataya. Because it is advitiya, non-dual. Always fear is because of duality. Dvaitadhi bhayam bhavati. Brahma being Brahma, which is Atma, as pointed out as Akshini Purushaha, so being advitiya, so bhiti hetva bhavacha. Dvaita, duality, is the cause of bhiti, fear, or samsara, sorrow. Samsara, which is nothing but sorrow. So bhite, bhiti hetva bhavacha, because of absence of any cause of fear, nirbhayam iti iryate. Brahma is said to be, iryate is said to be nirbhayam abhayam, free from fear. In Brahma there is no fear. That is what Gaudapada Acharya in one of the Karika of Mandukya says, abhaye bhaya darshinaha. A samsari is a dreaded of gaining the knowledge of Atma Brahma, which is such a foolishness that Brahma which is abhaya, he is dreaded. And samsara which is nothing but sabhaya, full of fear, he runs after, taking it to be free from fear. That is a perverted intellect. Aviveka, mudhatva. So therefore, nirbhayam iti iriyate. So in this manner, Prajapati has taught the Atma Swarupa to Indra and Virochana. What was it? Yaha eshaha akshini purushaha drishyate eshaha atma iti ha uvacha. Etad amrutam abhayam etad brahma. The question is whether Indra and Virochana got the knowledge. Unfortunately, both of them did not understand the teaching properly and therefore could not gain the knowledge. Because the mind was not yet ready, in spite of having taken to the life of Brahmacharya for 32 years. The mind was so much full of all these regal samskaras of royal life that still it has not come out of the clutches of Rajoguna, which they were predominantly filled with. So both could not understand the tatparya, the import of teaching of Prajapati. So what was the reason? Let us see. Prajapatyukti tatparyam na buddhetamubhavati. Rajyavasanaya chittam तदीयं राजसं खलु। उभौ अपि प्रजापत्युक्तितात्पर्यं न अबुद्धेता न अबुद्धेता तदीयं चित्तं राज्यवासनया राजसं खलु। उभवपि बोथ ऑफ देम हु इंद्र एंड विरोधी प्रजापत्युक्ति तात्पर्यम् प्रजापतेः उक्तेः तात्पर्य तात्पर्य द एसेंस द इंपोर्ट ऑफ उक्ति द टीचिंग ऑफ प्रजापति न अबुद्धेता डिड नॉट अंडरस्टैंड they didn't understand the import of the teaching. Why? What is the reason? Because their chitta antakarna was still like this. Tadiyam chittam. So their mind, rajyavasanaya, being still associated with the regal power, etc., and with those regal samskaras, Rajasam khalu, certainly it was predominantly rajasic in nature. Sattva guna was still lacking in them. So rajya vasanaya, because of the vasana, samskaras pertaining to rajya means regal samskaras, royal samskaras, administration, bhoga, this, that. So, it was highly rajasic still in spite of 32 years of brahmacharya. Then what did they understand? Okay, if they have not understood properly, either they have not understood at all or they have misunderstood. So which of the two pertains to these people? They had misunderstood. How do you say? By their question it is clear. If they had not understood at all, they would have requested Prajapati that please repeat, we have not understood, or please elaborate. On the contrary, they have misunderstood and they want to know whether what they have understood is correct or not by asking a question. So what they had misunderstood was, Prajapati pointed out the Purusha is the eyes. They took it very literally. If a person stands in front of you, in your pupil, in your eyes, the pupil, the reflection of the person in front is seen. You can verify somewhere. In fact, once it happened many years ago, I had been to a place. So, and was staying on the sixth floor. And that was the only multi-storied building in a surrounding of 4-5 kilometers. One very seasoned photographer said, Swamiji, I will take your photograph. Okay. So he came. And I was standing facing a very wide window which was totally open. And he's focusing. The way he was focusing and to take a close-up, way he was proceeding, I was amused. Anyway, he was actually a CID photographer. So he took, when the photograph came, when I saw the photograph, I could very clearly see the reflection of this person in my pupil, because backdrop was open sky, and in contrast to that, this figure, the shadow, was prominently projected. So, eteshu anteshu madheshu parikhyayate is seen, is perceived. So that is what he confirmed. Still here, further doubt is possible. Didn't Prajapati suspect that they will again misunderstand this eshaha for the reflection cast in water or mirror, like the reflection in the eye? Yes, he did know, but he thought of a remedy for correcting it. First he confirmed, yes, same Atma is known, and they will misunderstand that it is the actual reflection. For that, he had in mind certain demonstration by which Indra and Virochana will be able to get rid of the wrong notion that the reflection is Atma, and that he is employing. We'll see what is that demonstration. But unfortunately, in spite of two demonstrations, Indra and Virochana fail to detect that Chaya Atma cannot be Atma. Let us see now. Svenakshinyupadishto yaha sasarvatrapi tishthati. Ityuktvopayatastau dvau. बोधयामीत्यमन्यत स्वेन यः अक्षिणी उपदिष्टः सः सर्वत्र अपि तिष्ठति. इति उक्त्वा उपायतः तौ द्वौ बोधयामि इति अमन्यत. नाउ व्हाट एक्चुअली प्रजापति मीन्स बाय एषः. इन हिज आंसर एष उ एव एतेषु सर्वेषु अन्तेषु परिख्यायते. दिस इज व्हाट इज मेंट बाय एष, दिस बाय प्रजापति. व्हाट इज इट? स्वेन यः अक्षिणी उपदिष्टः. स्वेन मीन्स बाय मी, मी मीन्स हु? बाय प्रजापति. सो कंसिडर बाय मी मीन्स प्रजापति. यः द आत्मा उपदिष्टः टॉट हाउ अक्षिणी एज अक्षिणी पुरुषः सः द सेम आत्मा सर्वत्र अपि तिष्ठति. इट अबाइड्स इन ऑल इन एट एवरी प्लेस इन एवरीथिंग. हाउ? बिकॉज दैट आत्मा इज सर्वाधिष्ठान. It is the adhishthana of everything. Then what about their misunderstanding? They have already misunderstood. They may misunderstand this esha for the chayatma also, for which he has already planned a remedy. Iti uktva, having said so, that the atma pointed out in the eyes is the atma in everything, including water, mirror, or any other reflecting surface, says, iti uktva, having said so, upayataha, by certain means. Here the means means the demonstration. By demonstration, what is called as udasharava drishtanta, the illustration of water in a shallow pan or a shallow dish. So what he is going to do is, he is going to ask them to bring a pan filled with water, a shallow dish filled with water, and then he is going to tell them to do something. So he has got a plan in his mind. So upayata, by such demonstration, tau dvau, both of them. Who are those both of them? This tau dvau is accusative dual. Nominative dual also is tau dvau, but here it is accusative dual. Tau dvau. Bodhayami, I will teach them. Iti amanyata, so he considers. Whatever misunderstanding they have got, I will be able to dispel them by the demonstration of the pan filled with the water. So with this, he is telling certain things to them. So what he is going to tell you, he has told now, what he is going to tell you. So here is a pan or a shallow dish filled up with water. He says, both of you look in that. And having looked there, whatever you have not understood, please ask me. I will answer. So now, assume there is a pan, a shallow dish filled with water, and you are looking into it. What are you going to look? Your reflection. So that is what they saw. And as a, is this that reflection that is Atma? Again the same problem. So Prajapati still doesn't want to correct them. He thought of another plan. Well, do one thing. Now you go and tomorrow you come. But how? With your hair trimmed, nails etc. trimmed and wearing the royal dress. Please keep in mind, they were living a life of brahmachari. No haircut, no nail cutting, and ordinary clothes they were wearing and not the royal dress. So, Prajapati told them to have a shave, hair cut, nails cut, and with regal dress, do come tomorrow. And next day, he asked them to see in the pan again, pan filled with water. They see the reflection and ask the same thing. Is this Atma? Now the question comes, what actually Prajapati had in mind in making them see their reflection first in the condition they are there as brahmacharis? And thereafterwards with all decorations as kings. So what was it? Will be seen afterwards. Prajapati intended to point them out by this demonstration that the reflection which is subject to change cannot be nirvikari atma. But they have not caught the point. Before that, let us see what happens. Sharave jala yukteva kevalau vikshatau punaha Sharave jala yukteva kevalau vikshatau punaha सालंकारावेक्षाथ छायामात्मेति बुध्यतां जलयुक्तेवा शरावे केवलौ वीक्ष अथ तौ पुनः सालंकारौ अवेक्ष छायां आत्मा न इति बुध्यतां छायां आत्मा न इति बुध्यतां दिस वॉज द प्लान ऑफ प्रजापति. जलयुक्ते शरावेवा, दैट वा हैज नो मीनिंग देयर. इन सम अदर बुक द वा इज एब्सेंट. जलयुक्ते शरावे, शराव एलो डिश ए पैन, जलयुक्ते फील्ड विथ वाटर. केवल वीक्ष फर्स्ट हैविंग सीन देम विदाउट प्रॉपर ड्रेसिंग, विदाउट डेकोरेशन. केवल मीन्स मियरली मीन्स विदाउट डेकोरेशन एज किंग्स, बट एज अ ब्रह्मचारी बट इन वॉट एवर ड्रेस देवर देयर, विदाउट शेव, विदाउट कटिंग द नेल्स एक्सेट्रा. केवल वीक्ष तव बोथ ऑफ देम. पुनः आफ्टरवर्ड्स सालंकारौ विद ऑल डेकोरेशन, विथ अ हेयर ट्रिम्ड, नेल्स ट्रिम्ड, विथ अ वेयरिंग द रॉयल ड्रेस. सो सालंकारौ अवेक्ष अथ मीन्स आफ्टरवर्ड तव बोथ ऑफ देम. पुनः सालंकारौ अवेक्ष विथ सच रॉयल ड्रेस, हैविंग सीन देम अगेन. सो लेट देम फाइंड आउट छायाम आत्मा न इति बुध्यताम. छाया एज नॉट द आत्मा, बुध्यताम मे देम बोथ नो अंडरस्टैंड. लेट देम बोथ अंडरस्टैंड दैट रिफ्लेक्शन कैनॉट बी आत्मा.